it shine. Oh, this little light of mine. Gonna let it shine.
This march today is to commemorate the activities that took place in 1963.
In 1963, if you so much as lifted a voice in one sentence of dissent from the status quo, or so much as lifted one finger to do anything about your oppositional viewpoint, everything you were, everything you had, and everything you wanted to ever be immediately was in dire jeopardy.
When students rose up against an oppressed system to say things must change, that cry went out so loudly that it reached all the way to Birmingham-Southern campus. And only one student on that day heard that cry, and that was Marti Turnipseed.
That was the way it was. Not just how it was when black citizens and my sister went to Woolworths and broke the Jim Crow laws there. That's how it was every hour of every day for anyone, black or white, who had a conscience that would not quit.
Marti Turnipseed took it upon herself to join with the many voices to say it's time for a change in the Jim Crow laws that existed back then.
But I remind us, as Marti and others of that era would, that no matter what the cost was paid by a white person in the movement, and there were costs paid by whites,
to say that one person can make a difference.
Nonetheless, it was my black brothers and sisters who lived the hell the rest of us were responding to. This is the sorrowful, shameful, historic, real truth. Like in individual family units, all the children, all of us, are brothers and sisters of one another. It is that simple, and it is that profound.
It took an entire group of people to make a difference.
And this spirit enveloped the movement, and it lifted downcast eyes, and it gave energy to weary feet, and it energized the old, and it inspired the young, and it gave birth to an irrepressible hope and a stubborn will to keep on keeping on.
It took black folks, it took white folks, it took Baptists, it took Methodists, it took Catholics, it took Jews, it took a rainbow of people to say we must change our society.
This spirit captured the imagination of the world.
We not only changed Birmingham, we not only changed Alabama, we not only changed the United States, but we changed the world.
And put a revolutionary feeling of renewed worth and dignity into the veins of countless people in places near at hand and far away.
In 1993, I had the opportunity to meet Nelson Mandela. And Mandela said that one of the things that kept him uplifted during his 26 years of imprisonment was the fact that if change could come to Birmingham, Alabama, and the South, then change could come to South Africa. That message has gone around the world. So thank you all. I welcome you.
I've been in the storm. So